Hey guys, welcome back to another bump date. I am technically 36 weeks, but this video is going to be 35 and 36 weeks because I failed to do it last week. Last week was so chaotic. We had so much stuff going on, and the day I actually usually film is right before my next week. So I usually film on Thursdays, and Friday is like the beginning of a new week for me, and we had pictures last week. So we finally got our maternity pictures done. So glad that they were all done. So I'm actually going to do 35 weeks first, and then I'll touch on some 36 weeks because that's what I'm actually am now. So 35 weeks, some of the things that I have been experiencing more is I've been a lot more hungrier, craving so much ice, craving ice cream, milkshakes, strawberry, anything. And I used to be like obsessed with peanut butter like in the beginning, but not really now. I really never have like any food cravings. Sometimes I'll see something, but for the most part, it's like really hard to actually find something that I like. I have been getting a lot of numbness like right under my chest on my side. But I actually went to the doctor today and they just reassured me that I'm having back spasms in the back and the nerve kind of like reaches over, and that's kind of why I'm having some numbness. Last week started getting way more uncomfortable to sleep and getting up a lot more at night. For the most part, most nights I would only get up maybe one time, if not, none. Because I stay up really late, usually about till close to about 11:30, 11:45 every night. So I try to go pee a lot throughout the day so I'm not up during the night, because it is so uncomfortable at night. Just getting really bad back pains. I had a few contractions, nothing really major. I mean, just like slightly here and there. So 35 weeks, I feel like it just went by so quick. But nesting definitely hit me last week. I started getting a lot of my big chores that I've been wanting to do, and just like some deep cleaning things that I want to get done before I have the baby, because I am having a C-section, so I know that I'm going to be down a little bit longer. So doing some of the things that I normally can do, I wanted to get out of the way just so I don't have to worry about them. Although, now that I really think about it, like, I don't know why I didn't think about it before, but now I'm thinking, like, I definitely, if I get to that point where my house is just crazy and I cannot keep up, I'm definitely thinking about just paying somebody to come and clean, even though Troy would probably think I'm crazy, but I just think it'll just help so much instead of, like, worrying about getting everything done. So anyways, fast forward to 36 weeks. Man, it has been, to be honest with you, I felt really good throughout most of the pregnancy, but it has definitely hit me this week. Like, I'm really big. It's really hard to fit in anything. Like I said, my back, it just hurts all the time. Feeling way more tired. And throughout the day, I need to take more, breaks. Like when I do something, if I'm doing something like trying to clean up a lot, I try to give myself breaks in between because I'm just getting really uncomfortable really quickly. Getting more uncomfortable, especially when laying down. Still having a lot of the tingling pain. Like, it's not really pain. It's just like uncomfortable, I guess you would say. And then I started at night. Like, it usually hits me at night and then it lasts some throughout the day. But my hand is swelling a little bit, and so it's getting like tingly. The doctor said it could be like kind of seem like carpal tunnel, and they said if it gets too bad that you can put a brace on it. You can get it from the store, but it's just kind of swelling just a little bit in one of my hands. It's just so weird, and it hurts to do anything with it, which is so weird. I've never really had that kind of pain before. So that's one kind of thing that's just been a little bit annoying, because like if I'm doing something too much with this hand, or if I'm doing anything at all, especially for the first few hours after I wake up, it hurts really bad. So I've just been trying not to sleep on it because I thought at first, well, maybe that's what it was. But the doctor said, no, it can be a sign of pregnancy. But, you know, definitely keep an eye on it if, like, my feet are swelling or anything like that. The swelling, which it hasn't happened. So fingers crossed it doesn't happen. So, you know, I've just been really taking a lot of, you know, making sure that I keep track of it and making sure that it doesn't get really terrible. Getting a lot of pelvic pain. It's just getting harder and harder, I think, every week. Getting more and more uncomfortable. This week, I noticed, like, I'm way more off balance than normal. And I read that in my What Not to Expect app. A lot of women say, like, around this time that they've felt like that. See, I have vertigo. And I tend to often feel like that. So I don't know if it's that. Or if it is just the pregnancy, which definitely could be, but definitely felt like there's, like, last week when we do it to Grayson's game, like, I was trying to help him, but I just felt, like, really dizzy, off balance, so a lot more times where I feel like, okay, I need to sit down for a second, especially when I'm trying to overdo it or doing too much. My dog is trying to get in the crib. There's nothing in there. So, yeah, that's just one of the things. One day, I think, maybe one or two days, it's kind of seemed like my feet were swelling. But I don't really know. I don't really think that they were. I think I was just kind of, like, self-conscious about it because Troy had mentioned something about I was swollen really bad with when I was pregnant with Blake. But I definitely have not been like that with this one. And it's, again, some of the foods and stuff, like, still really loving the ice, strawberry, everything. But no real, like, food cravings at this point. I'm just like the other day I wanted Subway, but, you know, it's just like, I guess if somebody says something that sounds good, it's like, oh, okay, sounds good. But there's nothing really, like, I, like, have to have, like, except for strawberry, like, ice cream and milkshake. That's, like, really what I want right now. So, or I'm into, like, these strawberry popsicles, too. That's what I've really been trying to eat more. Not a lot of the ice cream because, of course, I don't want all those extra calories, especially at the end because I gotta get it off. So, anyways, that's kind of, like, a wrap-up between my 35 and 36 weeks being pregnant. We literally, I think, have, like, 19 days now. It's, like, mid-April. So we are definitely down to the wire for sure. Ready to have this little baby. I pretty much got in the nursery mostly set up. I think, like, one of the last things that I really need to do is go through the clothes and go ahead and wash them. I got the diaper bag, which I've shown you guys before. I just need to finish packing this. I don't have any clothes in here. I just kind of have, just kind of like the necessities. So I really need to finish this bag. I thought for sure I would have it done by this time, but the problem is that I need to wash those clothes. I have a few other things that were coming in, so I was just trying to wait for those last few things, but I can always do that in a separate load, so I really need to get it together, but I am for sure growing. I feel like I'm definitely, like, popped out of there, and as you can see, like, my shirts are starting to get so short, so I'm so glad I'm almost at the end, too, and I'm glad that the weather is, like, holding up. It's been, like, it's going to be, like, 60s for the next few weeks, so I'm just loving that. It's not going to be, like, extreme hot while I'm still pregnant, especially this pregnant, because I'm just, like, dying of heat. So, thank you guys for tuning in to our channel. Thanks for watching and keeping posted. I know we haven't been that great with posting a lot of things through this pregnancy. It's just been kind of difficult with the whole, you know, school thing and being at home. And so we're really trying to get through it, but really trying to get more consistent and being able to put more stuff out for you guys. But we definitely want to document this time, even though I kind of started late. I really wish I would have started earlier, but, you know, better late than never. And we are so excited to meet our baby girl in like 19 days. So you'll definitely see some more videos soon, and we'll see you guys later. Peace.